Starry, starry night.
Hello, my name is Miss Deja, and I work at the Mono Arts Council. Today, we will be learning about the artist Vincent Van Gogh. We'll look at a slideshow to get to know his artwork, get to know him, and see how he used brushstrokes and lines to express feelings and texture. The supplies that you will need today are black construction paper, We will be using this landscape, not portrait. So landscape. You will also need a set of oil pastels. If they are broken, that is okay. That will work really well for this lesson. You'll also need a pencil. So make sure your pencil's sharpened. And a sheet of like scratch paper to practice on. So that could be lined paper, any paper you don't mind practicing on. So what are we doing today? Well, we will be making our own starry night scenes. You'll have plenty of opportunity to add your own details, use what colors you want. And I will go over the supplies once again at the end of the slideshow. This is a self-portrait of Vincent Van Gogh. Notice the space behind his head, all around his head. That is known as the background. And can you see all of those brush strokes and the different colors? Well, Van Gogh liked showing the brush strokes in his artwork instead of blending in the different colors that he was adding onto his pictures. He felt that the brush strokes helped express feelings and add details to his work. So instead of mixing colors on a palette, he would put those colors directly onto the canvas and not mix them. When Van Gogh was alive, he had a hard time selling his work. And the only person who believed in him was his brother, Theo. That made Vincent very sad because he loved his work. So notice his hair on his head, the hair on the face, hair on his eyebrows, even the bags under his eyes, lots of texture. And texture is when you can feel the photo with your eyes. This is called The Sunflowers in a Vase. Vincent created this picture for an artist whom he liked very much. And that was Paul Gauguin. Yellow was Vincent's favorite color. And so he used that as a way to make Paul feel more at home when he visited Vincent's house. He actually painted a bunch of different pictures of sunflowers for Paul. Lots of texture in this picture, and he used the texture in certain parts of his paintings because that's where he wanted your eyes to go to first. So notice that there's lots of texture on the flowers, the leaves of the flowers, even the vase. And can you see where Vincent signed his name? It's in red writing right onto the vase. So he included his signature into the picture. This is the Starry Night. This is the picture that we are going to use as inspiration for our artwork today. He made this painting look as if the stars were moving. And the way he did that was to add spirals or circles around the stars. And so he would keep making the spiral go round and round and around until it swept away. And so those different lines in the sky, the lines in the tree, even though the tree is in the shadows, you can still see those brushstrokes that are giving it some texture. So I'd like you to try something with me. Go ahead and put one of your hands up to the screen, like you're going to give me a high five. And then make a one with your hand, your index finger, and then poke a little dot in the sky. Now that you have your dot, go and make a circle around that dot, and then just keep going around and around, making your circle bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger until it sweeps away. Well, that is what Vincent Van Gogh did with the stars in the Starry Night here. So keep that in mind for when we're making our own pictures after the slideshow. This is called Peach Trees in Bloom. Lots of texture in this picture. From the clouds up on the top of the painting, notice the different lines and brushstrokes of the darker blue paint that Vincent added in to give some texture to the clouds and the sky. The trees, the blossoming peach trees, Vincent added in just dots of white paint all around and did not blend that in. There's also a lot of texture in the fence. From the different lines and colors that you see on there, it really gives the effect that that fence is kind of older. And all the way to down to the grass that's right in front of the fence. The different brush strokes really makes you feel like you can feel what that grass might feel like. So let's take a look at this a little bit closer. And this is a close-up of the peach trees in bloom. Vincent Van Gogh knew that our eyes could tell texture without our hands feeling it. So again, notice the white flowers that Vincent just used, you know, drops of white paint to express them. Even the different colors and lines of the fence, lots of texture there just from his brush strokes and lines. This was one of Vincent Van Gogh's last paintings, and he died at 37 years old, and he was only painting the last 10 years of his life. This is called The Red Vineyard. There are workers picking grapes. Vincent Van Gogh used colors to express the time of the year and the season in his pictures. So notice the yellow, orange, and red colors that is supposed to give the effect that it is autumn or fall. As we mentioned, Vincent Van Gogh painted the last 10 years of his life. He created almost 1,700 works of art. So that is a combination of paintings and drawings of almost 1,700 paintings and drawings that he created in just 10 years. So that means that he created something every day the last 10 years of his life. And sadly, he only sold one piece before he died, and it sold for $80. His popularity sadly came after he died. So unfortunately for Vincent, he did not know how loved and appreciated he was and his work was while he was alive. So Vincent Van Gogh, born in 1853, and he died in 1890. So now that we've seen some examples of how Vincent used brushstrokes and lines to add texture to his artwork, let's now do the same thing in our own Starry Night pictures. So don't forget that the supplies you will need are one sheet of black construction paper, one sheet of black construction paper. We'll use this landscape or hot dog and not portrait. You'll also need a set of oil pastels. So just one set of oil pastels, and they can be broken. You will need a pencil. Make sure your pencil's sharpened. And a sheet of scratch or scrap paper for you to practice on. So that can be lined paper, any paper you don't mind practicing the spirals on. If you do not have these supplies, you can use crayons instead and any sheet of dark paper, preferably. So that can be blue or purple. And if not, then you can just use white paper. So once again, we are creating our own Starry Night scenes. All right. So make sure that your pencil is sharpened. You have that right in front of you. And you have your sheet of scratch or scrap paper so that we can practice our spirals before we create our own Starry Night pictures. All right, so make sure you have your white or scrap paper right in front of you to practice on. And let's practice by making this spiral. So choose the left or right side of your paper and make a dot somewhere. So make a dot and then start circling around that dot. Circling, and this circle is going to continue. So it's not going to be just one circle that kind of ends. It's going to continue to go around and around and around the dot until it sweeps away. So I'd say go around the dot at least 5 times and practice that for a couple of minutes to make sure that you get used to making a spiral. So a couple spirals, at least 1 or 2, to make sure you get that down. Next, we will make a broken lined spiral. So make sure that you make a dot. And then when you start circling around the dot, you're going to make a bunch of broken lines or dashes. So instead of making a continuous line around, you're going to make a line, lift your pencil up, make a line, lift your pencil up, make another line, lift your pencil, make another line, lift, line, lift. And so it's kind of like a snail shell. We're going to keep going around. But instead, with this one, you're going to make a bunch of subtraction signs or little dashes going around and around. So practice making these broken spirals, these broken lined spirals. I'd say do a couple, make sure you get that down before we start with our pictures. And I would go around the dot at least 5 times again for the broken line spirals. And when you feel like you've practiced enough, get your black construction paper. Remember, we are using this landscape and not
portrait. Get your black construction paper and your black oil pastel. So black construction paper and black oil pastel. Use your whole hand to measure from the bottom of the paper. Use your whole hand to measure from the bottom edge of the paper. Use your black oil pastel to mark above the hand with a little line. And the line does not have to be very big. And now we'll add some landscape across the paper using that line as measurement. So using your black oil pastel, make a little curved line for the landscape, or maybe your landscape's in the mountains, and that's okay too. And I used my whole hand to measure from the bottom edge of the paper. Now choose the yellow or white oil pastel. So choose yellow or white oil pastel to make at least one dot in your sky. We're going to start making some stars, but first we'll need to add a dot. So choose anywhere from 1 to 5 dots to make the spiral in your sky. And that can be using the yellow or the white oil pastel, yellow or white. Just make at least one dot in the sky, and then use any colors you want to start adding the spiral around your dots. So choose one to be your main spiral, and then start making those broken lines circling around the dot. And if your spirals are bigger or wider than mine, that is okay. So don't worry about it looking exactly like mine. Just try your best, and most importantly, have fun. And don't be afraid to use lots of different colors for your spirals. And then just keep going out until it sweeps away. And you want the spirals to go out to the edge of the paper. And think about what happens when it runs into the landscape. We don't want to draw right on top of the landscape. It would kind of disappear behind it. So notice I hit my landscape. I'm just going to continue where I know it would pick up on the other side. And think about what happens when the spirals run into each other too. And you can use whatever colors you want, wherever you want, whenever you want.
Paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills. Sketch the trees and the daffodils. Catch the breeze and the winter chills in colors on the snowy linen land. Now I understand what you tried to say to me.
And notice how I'm continuing my spiral even when it's going to go out into the universe. But where would it pick back up? It's going to come back over here. So keep that in mind too.
Perhaps they'll listen now.
And you want your spirals to go to the edge of the paper and to the edge of where the landscape starts as well.
Swirling clouds in violet haze reflect in Vincent's eyes of china blue, colors changing hue. Morning fields of amber grain, weathered faces lined in pain, are soothed beneath the artist's loving hand. Now I understand what you tried to say to me and how you suffered for your sanity and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how.
When you're done with your spiral, we'll add some color to the landscape. So you can choose any colors you want, but turn that color that you use on its side, and then you're gonna go across the landscape.
Starry, starry night, you took your life as lovers often do.
So instead of using it like you'd usually use a crown or a pen, you want to turn the oil pastel onto its side.
Starry, starry night. Portraits hung in empty halls. Frameless heads on nameless walls. With eyes that watch the world and can't forget, like the strangers that you've met.
You can use as many different colors as you want.
Ragged clothes, a silver thorn, a bloody rose, lie crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me and how you suffered for your sanity and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never.
And don't forget to sign your name on the front or back of your picture.